Anushka Puri Award, ILS Law Competitive, UPSC Competitive Study Center सुरू केलं. या सेंटरतर्फे आपण विविध तज्ज्ञांचं मार्गदर्शन घेत असतो. याचाच एक भाग म्हणून आता पण धर्माधिकारी सरांना बोलत आहे. मी तुमची उत्कंठा जास्ती वाढणार नाही आहे. आपण सरांना विनंती करू आणि आपण त्यांचं भाषण ऐकूया.
सरांचा परिचय सर्वांना माहितच आहे. तरी मी श्रीराम दादांना अशी विनंती करतो की त्यांनी अल्पशा शब्दांमध्ये सरांची ओळख आपण सर्वांना करून द्यावी.
सरांचा परिचय करणे एवढा मी मोठा नाहीये आणि सरांबरोबर स्टेजवर बसणे एवढा तर मी खचितच मोठा नाहीये. परंतु एक थोडक्या शब्दांमध्ये समोर बसलेली व्यक्ती कोण आहे, कारण जर हाच काळ जर 60-70 वर्षांपूर्वीचा असता तर 60-70 वर्षांपूर्वी मी सरांची ओळख करून देण्यासाठी उभा राहिलो नसतो. कारण 60-70 वर्षांपूर्वीचा काळ हा कर्तृत्व जाणून माणसाला मान आणि त्याची प्रतिष्ठा ठरवणारा होता. पण आजकालचा काळ हा कपड्यांमधून प्रतिष्ठा ठरवणार आहे, म्हणून कर्तृत्वाची ओळख करून देणार. 10 वर्ष मुक्त पत्रकारिता करणं, सोशल ऍक्टिव्हिटीज मध्ये ऍक्टिव्ह असणं आणि अचानक मनात एखादी गोष्ट येणं आणि तलाठी नाही, तहसीलदार नाही, डीवायएसपी नाही, एसपी नाही, तर आयएएस या पदावर युपीएससीची परीक्षा देऊन पास होऊन जाणं, याच्यासाठी मनाची खूप मोठी तयारी लागते. आणि ती मनाची मोठी तयारी करून आयएएस झाल्यानंतर वेगवेगळ्या पदांवर अतिशय ऐशोरामाचं आयुष्य असताना, अतिशय प्रतिष्ठा असताना, सगळीकडं मान मिळत असताना सुद्धा मनात पुन्हा एकदा गोष्ट येऊन त्या आयएएस पदाचा राजीनामा देऊन चाणक्य मंडळ परिवार स्थापन करणार, याच्यासाठी खूप मोठी मनाची तयारी आहे. आणि तेवढ्या मनाच्या मोठा तेवढ्या मनाची मोठी तयारी असणारा माणूस आपल्याला वक्ते म्हणून लागले. आजपर्यंत कितीतरी आयएएस, कितीतरी आयपीएस, कितीतरी डीवायएसपी, एसपी सरांच्या हातातून विद्यार्थी म्हणून पास झालेले, तरी त्या माणसाला अभिमान या काही गोष्टीचा नाही. खरंच मी स्वतःला नशीबवान समजतो किंवा स्वतःच माझं लक्ष चांगलं आहे म्हणतो की अशी व्यक्ती आजही महाराष्ट्रामध्ये चांगलं प्रतिष्ठेचं स्थान प्राप्त करून सर्व जनसामान्यांमध्ये काम करतात. दुसरी गोष्ट, चाणक्य मंडळ परिवार स्थापन करून वेगवेगळ्या ग्रामीण भागातील शेतकऱ्यांच्या मुलांना, ग्रामीण भागातील सर्व विद्यार्थ्यांना ज्यांची परिस्थिती नाही अशा मार्गदर्शन करून त्यांना पुन्हा स्पर्धा परीक्षेच्या पातळीवर उभे करणं आणि स्पर्धा परीक्षेच्या पातळीवर उभा करून त्यांना लाल दिव्याचं स्वप्न दाखवून ते लाल दिव्याचं स्वप्न त्यांना पूर्ण करायला लावणं ही खूप मोठी गोष्ट आहे. ते सर करतात आणि आपण त्यांचे आभार मानू. मी जास्त वेळ तुमचा घेणार नाही, फक्त एवढंच सांगतो की 2 वर्षांपूर्वी 10 मार्च म्हणजे याच तारखेला आयएलएस कॉम्पिटिटिव्ह एक्झाम ची स्थापना झाली होती. डॉक्टर डी आर पाटील सर, एस पी आणि जितेंद्र वाघ डेप्युटी कलेक्टर यांनी इनॉग्रेशन केलं होतं. ऑडिटोरियमला कार्यक्रम झाला होता. विशेष म्हणजे त्या कार्यक्रमाला दीपा पातुरकर मॅडम उपस्थित होते. आजच्याही कार्यक्रमात दीपा पातुरकर मॅडम उपस्थित आहेत. हा माझा शेवटचा कार्यक्रम आहे आणि शेवटचा कार्यक्रमही अतिशय चांगल्या पाहुण्यांच्या उपस्थितीमध्ये होतोय, याचा मला आनंद आहे. जास्त तुम्हाला वाट बघायला लावत नाही. मी एवढे माझे शब्द आणि जे काही मानाची स्थानं आहेत ती सरांना बहाल करतो आणि सरांनी याच्यानंतर कार्यक्रमाला सुरुवात करावी आणि सर्व विद्यार्थ्यांना मार्गदर्शन करावं अशी विनंती करतो. आणि सर आले याच्याबद्दल सरांचा आभार मानतो. धन्यवाद.
तर कुठल्याही क्षणाची विलंबता न करता मी सर धर्माधिकारी सरांना अशी विनंती करतो की त्यांनी उपस्थितांना आजच्या या विषयावर मार्गदर्शन करावे.
तरीही तो कधीही जुना होत नाही. असा असा माझा पहिला आणि सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचा मुद्दा ते म्हणजे सर्वांना सर्व काळ सर्व शुभेच्छा हे माझं लाडकं वाक्य आहे. ऑल माय बेस्ट विशेस टू ऑल ऑफ यू. द बेस्ट विशेस आर इटर्नल, बेस्ट विशेस आर अनकंडिशनल. इथले आपला आताचा आपला विषय भारतासमोरील आव्हाने त्या फोकस स्पर्धा परीक्षेवर आणि हे निमित्त आहे ते तुमच्याशी त्या निमित्ताने संवाद हवा. बाहेर पडताना एक आनंद घेऊन तुम्ही बाहेर पडावे की काही मिळाला आणि तो ऍक्च्युली आय वॉज अबाउट टू आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन. So we had decided that on my reaching I would to raise this question, but then I saw that the entire program is going on in Marathi.
Yes.
So I just continued in Marathi. I would like you to tell me, would you like me to speak in Marathi or English?
Yes. Bilingual for you. Bilingual.
Marathi, Marathi, Hindi. Sir, English. Yeah. Sir, Marathi, Marathi, Marathi,
Yes sir, yes sir.
Sometimes when you have to convey some punchline, it has to be in Marathi. ते आम्ही इथे मी माझ्या माझ्या वेळेनुसार पोहोचलो होतो आणि आम्ही कॉमन रूम मध्ये जरा थांबलो होतो आणि सर गप्पा चालू होत्या. तरी मी दखल घेतलीच की कोणतरी चहा घेऊन आले then in the light of restricted time, if at all I am to pass on everything to you, I am going to share one kissa with you. One kissa, a joke, it says everything. I am going to say if I had only 5 or 10 minutes, instead of like chattering around the subject, I would have only shared this kissa with you, which is a true one. And I will share the names later on. Then I would have, having shared this kissa, I would have said, just think about it for the rest of the day, for the rest of the evening, the night, tomorrow, the life, and you are going to keep seeing ever newer meanings into this kissa I am about to share with you. I do see the need to share it, because until I stood up to speak, I was seeing very serious faces. त्याचं पण वर्णन मराठीत करावं लागतं ते म्हणजे कळवण्यास अत्यंत दुःख. तर माझ्या तासाला जर मुलं मुली भयंकर चौकोनी चेहरे घेऊन बसलेले असले तर मला तास घेता येत नाही. इट्स इवन माय पर्सनल नीड दॅट यू पीपल शुड बी स्माइलिंग ऍट रेग्युलर इंटरवल्स, लाफिंग, हॅव्हिंग अ गुड लाफ, बिकॉज फॉर मी I'm telling you one huge summary in one line, that life is celebration and education is fun. Someday I'm going to write a book on aphorisms. Aphorisms by Avinash. Avinash aphorisms. Avinashi aphorisms. Some principles of life I have understood. That with all ups and downs which are there, with all asha nirasha, which is nobody can escape from it. Our choice is how do we face life. Then this one line summary, that life is celebration, utsav, jagde, nach utsav. That cha sarva asha nirasha sukha dukha yash apayasha sahi jagde nach utsav hai, janmala alo is ananda che sandhi. So life is celebration and education is fun. Education is not something to be done because there is no other choice, that we drag our feet, that there is lead in our feet and lead in our mind. So like unless we have some degree and unless we complete our law, you can't stand in the court, which means you can't earn some legitimate money, etc. I think of this as a very reactionary outlook towards life. Education is fun. That is something to be enjoyed. Pursuit of knowledge is the greatest pleasure. There is no pleasure greater than pursuit of knowledge. So here is this kissa. This is a story of three friends. Three jigri dost. Marathi kiwa Hindi doni madhe langoti yar mitra ha ahe shabd. Jigri dost. Now these three in the story are all men, but they can be all three women or any permutation combination of two men and one woman, two women and one. This is the story of three human beings, but in the story they happen to be all three boys who were best friends of each other, past and fastest friends of each other since their childhood in the school days. One of them was extraordinarily good at studies, and by studies I mean the study of books. So good that it's not like he would get 80-90% or something. He would always be the topper, and not only that he would be the topper, he would always get gold medal, that is the record. Always given any exam, he was so outstanding that he would always get the gold medal. The second one was so-so. He would not even take the risk of getting 90-95%, but he won't fail either. Every year he would go to the next class. You ask him what is your performance, and with a swollen chest he would say, I got second class on honors. But he would fail. And the third one, you ask him which year you are studying, which year of your degree, and he would say, this is my FY. The next year his answer would be, now I have gone into SYFY, then TYFY. So clearly 1 year used to be his India's 5-year plan. But see him on the playground playing any kabaddi, khokho or cricket, volleyball and football, and his movements like a tiger. Or see him organize, say, the college Sneha Sammelan gathering, and especially student council elections.
Last year.
Thank you. तसं तो बोलता नाही म्हणाला सरांच्या शेजारी त्यांनी शोभेस बोलला. आता माझं म्हणणे बसला ना आता तेवढं मोठं कर्तृत्व करायचं. थर्ड वन अँड यू लुक ॲट हिम इन हिज परफॉर्मन्स इन से द स्टुडंट काउन्सिल इलेक्शन फॉर द कॉलेज ऑर फॉर युनिव्हर्सिटी अँड ही वुड बी चॅम्पियन कलेक्टिंग फ्रेंड्स ensuring who stands for election, ensuring who sits down, who withdraws, if required who is to be kidnapped and taken over to Lonavala, Mahabaleshwar, elections are complete, that depends on the funding, available funding, but such three friends. I'm sure by listening to the story even you will understand that only these three kinds of people can be fast friends of each other. All three tops in studies, or all three like middle level in studies, or all three bookkar or bunkers, okay, cannot be friends of each other because they are each other's competitors in human fashion. But these three have no conflict of interest. If somebody troubles the academically intelligent student in the college, if somebody messes with him, this third chap gives him protection. Bachandi pakrun sare tere ko apne pair pe ghar jana hai ki nahi jana. In return for that, the intelligent chap tells the third person not to bother. I will tell you some formula, you just recite them. Patancha notes. मूळ कायदा वाचू नको, कायदा समजू नको, ते तेवढं हे रट्टे मान पठाणच्या नोट्स मध्ये चुका की माझ्या उत्तरात पण चुका. सो द इंटेलिजंट वन मॅक्सिम आय विल टेल यू सम फॉर्म्युला यू जस्ट रिसाइट देम. कंसामध्ये ए प्लस बी स्क्वेअर इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वेअर प्लस टू ए बी प्लस बी स्क्वेअर. परीक्षेमध्ये येते एक्स प्लस वाय स्क्वेअर. तिसरा मी तुला उत्तर नाही देऊ शकत. अँड द मिडल वन for studies he has connection with the brilliant student, and for protection on the college he is connected with the third, and both of them, the brilliant and the gunda, so to say, they need one such friend. Arshad Barsi circuit lagto na pratyekala three friends, and as is the standard idea of career plan, think that the score on in an exam is the only mark of intelligence. So you have to score like 95-96% etc. in 10th standard and secure admission to science faculty, because in 12th you need to get another 92-3-4-5-95.5-5-5-5-5-5-5-5-5-5 marks, because you need admission to medical or engineering. It's a misconception that a student, a youngster, is intelligent if only he or she gets admission to medical or engineering college. And if one doesn't succeed in securing admission to medical or engineering, then you start thinking of other alternatives, like, okay, maybe now I will complete BSc in pure science, maths, physics, chemistry, biology, etc. Or maybe try admission to ILS. And then commerce or arts, etc. By and large, this is the standard design for career plan. As per this design, our intelligent friend, he established a world record, the record for the board in like requisite 10th or 12th, secured admission to science. Again, established another record getting gold medal, and he wanted admission to engineering faculty, which he got. The years when this, to which this story belongs, electrical engineering was the branch in greatest demand. So this youngster picked up BE electrical engineering, which he got. Completed his BE electrical engineering in 4 years. He got gold medal for BE electrical engineering again. And then started looking around. Now what should I do with my life? Some job. Somebody brought it to his notice that there was a notification in newspapers for a class 1 post with Government of India. the name of the course was assistant executive engineer, and the requisite qualification set, he or she has to be electrical engineer. So somebody brought it to his notice, said this is practically made for you, why don't you apply, you will be selected. So he submitted his application, interview took place, and with his outstanding record, of course he was selected. So our most brilliant student started his career with class 1 post for assistant executive engineer with Government of India. The second friend, why would he get admission to science faculty? Because he did not have like 90% exemption. He could not secure admission to even commerce faculty. So finally, quietly, he took admission to arts faculty, completed his BA in political science, and then started looking around, what should I do? Somebody told him that with arts degree, you have a benefit in competitive exams. Why don't you try UPSC and try to be IAS officer? This is a misconception. For a career in competitive exam, every degree is useful. And if at all, some degree is more useful, it's the one you are doing. Law builds you up for competitive exams and also eventual career in through competitive exams. Because basically administration is essentially all about the constitution and performing within the framework of the constitution and law. So indeed the graduation, post-graduation in law builds you up. But at the end of the day, and basically for a career in and through competitive exams, it's not like a particular degree is required or particular degree is beneficial. But you will see that this is a misconception in most of the fields in human life, that people try to form simplistic formulae. And they need everything about life like 2 plus 2 equals 4. So you have an arts degree with political science as subject, you have certain benefit in UPSC. That's what this youngster was told. So why don't you try UPSC exam? Our middle-level friend appeared for UPSC exam, civil service exam, cleared it, was selected for IAS. And because he was selected for IAS, he joined Government of India as a senior officer of the more intelligent student who was engineering. Because IAS officers are always seniors.
Yes.
आम्ही लय शाळेत लागून गेलो हे इंग्लिश मध्ये सांगताच हा सौम्य वाटत इगोइस्टिक ॲरोगंट एक्सेट्रा नो ऑल एन अप्रोच आम्ही लय शाळेत लागून गेलो ते इंग्लिश मध्ये ट्रान्सलेट करत बट ॲन ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव्ह फॅक्ट इज विथ एन एक्सेप्शन ऑफ वन ऑर टू डिपार्टमेंट्स heads of almost all departments at the at central and state level are IAS officers. It's a generalist service. They are trained to handle any organizational outfit, whether they know about that outfit or not, but the art and science of running administration, and if at all that organization is to be turned around to give a good performance, that's what IAS officers are meant for, and they are worth calling themselves as IAS if they are capable of doing this. So our middle level student joined Government of India as the senior and the boss of this more intelligent student who started his career as assistant executive engineer. You will remember that we are left with the third friend. In good time he understood that study of books is not his cup of tea. Okay? So in good time, he joined the right party at the right time, contested election, got elected, and became the minister of both of them. And everything I want to tell you is done. It's here, it's in this. But the principles involved are that only your score in the exam is not the reflection of your. Only academic studies is not the only expression of intelligence. don't need to spend time telling you that it's not like only medical and engineering are good careers. If one is good at study of books, then one should pursue career related to study of books. In scientific language, that is called academic intelligence. If you have academic intelligence, pursue career in and through academics. But that academic intelligence also is not restricted to PCB, PCM, physics, chemistry, biology, and as that to applied science. Is medical and engineering good career? Yes, it is. It's a good career for those, let me say, those who like mathematics and understand mathematics are most welcome to join engineering faculty. But it's not like only those who like and understand maths are intelligent. And similarly, those who like biology and understand biology are most welcome to join the medical faculty. But it's not like only liking biology and understanding biology is a mark of intelligence. Now, it's a scientifically proven fact that everyone with the brain intact, if your brain is not damaged, the physiological damage, okay? Everyone is intelligent. But everyone's intelligence manifests in different fields. Our job is to find out where our intelligence works. That is our career. All careers are equal. All degrees are equal. As all human beings are equal. And all professions are equal. It's not like there is a hierarchy which in foul terms I describe it. It's not another caste system. That it's like only medical engineering is a good career, but failing to secure admission to medical engineering, you try pure science. But after 10th, if you can't get admission to science, then go for commerce. But if you don't have requisite marks for getting admission to a commerce college, then go to arts college. It's a very wrong conception. The right conception about developing one's own personality, developing one's own career is that everyone is intelligent.